this.
This takes concentric events, right? Centrals and concentric.
Suppose this is a disk, write down. This is a disk. You need to find out potential at a distance z along the axis. Charge per unit area is given as sigma. Charge per unit area is given as sigma. Let us concentrate now. Okay. I'll ask you to please pay attention. Or don't sit. You don't. You are not required. Think that it is just nonsense in the number. Okay? Find out potential over here. Treat entire disk as if it is made up of concentric rings. Use a ready-made formula for the ring and then integrate. The radius will increase. Radius of the ring will increase when you integrate. Another hint is, take a radius R ring whose width is dr, like this. Okay, R, small r is the radius and dr is the width. Try to do it yourself. Get the potential of this ring and then integrate small r from 0 to capital R. Capital R is the radius of the bigger thing, of the disk. Yeah, what I was thinking that since 4-hour class is there, so last 45 minutes we can have a small test. Or first 40, last 1 hour, 45 minutes to write a test, and last 15 minutes I'll discuss the test with you. Whatever we do on that day, I'll write down few questions, take it like a test, and we'll discuss with them. Okay? That way, those who want to just attend for 3 hours, they don't miss anything, and those who those who want to test themselves, I can write down questions and can discuss it. Because ultimately, when you struggle to solve a question, then only you learn. Okay? Doesn't matter how many soft problems I solve on the board. It's when you struggle. Okay, now tell me, what is the potential due to this ring of radius small r and width dr? How much is the charge on it? dq is what? Sigma into
2 pi r dr.
Sigma is charge per unit area. You have to multiply that with area of the ring. The width of the ring is dr. This is dq. And potential due to the ring was what? K times dq divided by root over r square plus z square. Isn't it? Right? So now I will substitute the value of dq, which is k sigma 2 pi r dr divided by the root over r square plus z square. This is my dv in terms of r. Okay? Total potential will be what? Integral of this. Okay? So when you integrate, you get the total potential. The limits will be from 0 to capital R. So sigma into 2 pi into k comes out. Sigma into pi k you just take outside. You get 0 to r, 2 r dr divided by root over r square plus z square. Okay? Now if you assume r square plus z square as t, you will get 2 r dr as dt. You know how to solve that integral, right? Integral is not yet done in mathematics. Okay, so it will be. So that is why I was hesitant to do this today. Anyways, let's solve it. Sigma into pi, k is what? 4 pi epsilon naught. Now, this you have assumed to be t. So when r is equal to 0, t is equal to z square. So this is z square, and when r is equal to capital R, it will be r square plus z square. Okay? So this is dt divided by root over t. Pi and pi gone. So you will get sigma by 4 epsilon naught. T raised to power minus half, right? Integral of T raised to power minus half dt is what? This will be T raised to power minus half plus 1 divided by minus half plus 1. Okay? So I will get 2 root T. Limits will be from z square to z square plus r square. So you will get sigma by 2 epsilon naught under root z square plus r square minus z. Okay, that is the potential due to the disk. Understood? So if I keep a small charge Q over here, what will be the potential energy between this and that? If I keep a small Q at a distance Z from the disk, what will be the potential energy? That into this. Simple. Understood? Right? You can see that when you are putting z equal to 0 over here, the formula changes to sigma r by 2 epsilon naught. So at the center will be when z equal to 0. Fine. This actually formula is required because in your CET also, in CET, JEE Mains and everywhere, you know, at least up to this, they expect you to know. That is why I got this. Okay, right on. Potential So if you have a solid metallic sphere, okay, and if you give it charge Q, what will happen to that charge? What will happen? It will distribute at the surface. Okay, so basically we are trying to deal with such scenario where charges are only at the surface. Okay, it can be an insulator also, but then the charges should be on the surface only. Okay, so suppose Q is distributed uniformly on the surface. I want you to find out potential at a distance R which is less than the radius of the sphere. Radius of the sphere. What will be the potential inside this hollow sphere? How much is the field? Electric field is what? Inside the hollow sphere?
Zero.
Electric field is zero. Anywhere inside, electric field is zero. Okay? So basically, anywhere inside, dV by dr is zero. What does it mean? Potential is constant. Anywhere you go, whether you are near the center or away from the center, as long as you are inside, potential is constant. Okay? So how much is that? You don't need any calculus, nothing. Just apply some logic, you'll get the answer. What will be the potential inside? As I tell me, a point on the surface will be a point inside or outside or both? Point on the surface will be where? Inside or outside?
It can be both.
It can be both. So it is actually both. Fine? Are you getting the point? That the point on the surface belongs to both inside as well as outside. Fine? So the formula for just outside is valid for potential on the surface, and that is also valid for potential just inside. Fine? Are you getting it? So tell me how much it is.
Q by R minus R.
R minus R? Sorry. Tell me, if the point is just outside, then the entire sphere will behave like a point charge located at the center. And if it is a point charge, potential should be KQ by capital R. And this point is just inside also. So potential just inside is this, and everywhere inside potential is constant. So So potential anywhere inside is this. Understood? Anywhere you go inside the hollow sphere, the potential is this. So one more time, if there is a charge, its potential will be kq by r, a point charge. Okay? If it is a ring, we know what is the potential. If it is a disc, we know what is the potential. And also if it is a hollow sphere. Okay? Similarly, there can be other type of charge distribution. We'll be doing it once you get comfortable with the calculus. Okay? And then we have found out potential due to the various charge distribution. And we also know that if potential is given, what will be the potential energy? If potential is V, and if you place a charge Q at a point where potential is V, the potential energy is Q into V. Simple, right? So we have found out the effect because of charge as a potential, and then effect on the charge because of the potential as potential energy. Understood this point? Potential due to charge and effect due to charge as potential, and effect on the charge due to outside potential as potential energy. Fine. Last chapter, the previous chapter, it was the electric field due to the charge and outside electric field on the charge as force. Okay. Then what we did previous chapter, we found the electric field due to a dipole, and then also found out what is the effect of external electric field on the dipole. Right? Now similarly we will be doing for potential also. Now we will be trying to find out what is the potential due to the dipole and what happens if you apply external potential on the dipole. Fine? Okay? Now let's try to find out potential. Till where this chapter is done in school? First chapter, half.
And then there are two classes, so it's same
one. There are two classes.
So physics teachers
are
one.
The school will resume only after your summer vacations.
No, I think so. Next week is our Monday.
This Monday is physics, but then when is summer vacation starting?
Next week Friday.
Okay. So, and then two weeks of summer vacation.
Two months.
So much study you can do, na?
Two months.
How many of you are going to celebrate the summer vacation? Nobody is going to outside. Do you have Australia?
Sir,
we
go out, come here.
So
in the holidays, when
send the holidays. See, you can study also. So you have like 2 months, as in eight classes of physics. Will be, this chapter will get over by mid of next session, next class of physics will be done. And then after that, we have 8 more classes. So we can complete 4 or 5 more chapters. Okay? And then just 8 or 9 more sessions are required to complete your 12 syllabus. 12 syllabus is very less. And then we can revise 11. Revise as in just revisit. Okay? So, fine. And since ray optics is also not there, when ray optics was there, we were finishing the syllabus by mid of October. Now if ray optics is not there, we can finish by mid of October or maybe starting of October. So this is what? April starting. April, May, June, July, August. Oh, 6 or 7 months. Long time. Anyways, let's do this. Potential due to a dipole. And let me tell you again that these two chapters are considered to be the most difficult. So do this properly so that you don't have headache of coming back to this chapter again and again. Once you do these two chapters, systematically work hard these two chapters, rest everything in physics becomes very, very straightforward. Okay? And in order to understand what kind of problem and variety, you need to first do the homework, right? And then solve at least 100 more questions. And then only you will get an idea. Don't just understand, okay, nothing but force it to have. Potential is there, potential energy is there. Unless until you solve a lot of questions, you will not understand what kind of varieties are there. Okay? Fine, so let's talk about the potential due to dipole. This is plus charge, this is minus charge, suppose. This is a dipole vector from negative to positive, yes or no? Tell me, what is the potential along this line, bisector? Along this line. Potential is? Zero. Right? So, when we deal with potential, we are not finding potential at special points like axial line and equatorial plane. But when we are dealing with electric field, we found only about axial and about equatorial. But since potential is a scalar, we have to just add them like numbers. We can find potential at any random location. Okay? So I try to find our potential over here. Okay? This, how you locate this point? You connect a line like this. This line makes angle theta and the distance is r. Fine? So theta and r are enough for this point P to be uniquely determined. Okay? This is the midpoint. Okay? You have to find out potential at P because of these plus and minus charge. Alright? Let me make a small construction. This distance, let us say, is R plus, and that distance is, let's say, R minus. So what should be the potential at point P in terms of R plus and R minus? Tell me. Potential due to this charge will be what at that point? KQY?
KQY.
R plus. R plus is the distance, na? This charge is the distance of R plus. So KQ by R plus, then for this it will be minus KQ by R minus. So minus of KQ by R minus, so negative charge. So this will be KQ 1 by R plus minus 1 by R minus. Okay? But R plus and R minus are not given. What is given is this distance is A from here to here. This is A and that distance is also A. And this is theta.